since I've gotten here. It's been complete joy. It's been a lot of work, but we enjoy it. We enjoy putting our heads down and working and staying connected and going out and just embracing the journey.
CJ obviously had a fantastic career night. A, what made that rim so big for him? And B, coming off COVID, working his way through things, how proud of him are you?
We're all extremely proud of CJ. When he plays with that type of force and that pace, his slow to fast was really good, and he just got it going. And the basket got bigger and bigger as the game progressed, and that's how he has to play. He may not have 40 every game, but he'll have major impacts, and he's done it throughout the course of the season, especially, you know, when we had guys out. But when he plays like that, he's tough to guard.
78 points between him and Zion. When you have a duo like that that can do that type of damage, it's going to be real hard to compete.
You know, those guys got it going. Once again, I don't know if they have a little competition going. Z gets 40, CJ gets 40, but, you know, we'll take it. And we want to continue to build our offense and obviously build our defense. I thought JV did a great job, Billy and the supporting cast, that trying to make Embiid take tough shots, trying to make Harden take tough shots. But they're a good team. They're well coached. I played for Doc in L.A., and they're going to be a force. So that was a good home win on our floor.
Zion has shot a lot of free throws, even for him, these last two games. Is there anything you're seeing, you know, he's doing differently to generate those free throws or anything like that?
Well, number one, he's in the gym working on his free throws, so he knows it's a big part of his game. And he's a guy that's getting downhill. He's playing with force, and he's tough to cover. So anytime he's playing like that, guys have to make a decision. And that's a part of our game, points in the paint, getting to the free throw line. It allows us to get open looks, especially from three.
What do you think about him, his relentlessness as a driver to just keep coming at you, even when he is taking hits?
I love to see it. And it's what makes Z special. Is that, you know, physically he can take all the bumps, all the hits, and he just keeps coming at you. And I wouldn't want to guard him.
And you guys have been striving for this all season, but obviously Z's tough enough to stop on his own. But when you guys are making threes the way you did tonight, how much did that open up the offense?
It's huge for us. Everything with our offense is predicated on our force and our pace and our ability to play basketball, 0.5 mentality, and then good to great. So we can get to the paint, and now guys are getting open looks because of Z's gravity, because of CJ's gravity, and even JV in the post. We're making the right plays. It's beautiful to see.
Yeah, you guys were going to a lot of dribble handoffs with CJ, a lot of pick and roll against Embiid, trying to force him to step up. How much was that, the mindset coming in, how much was that was kind of just an adjustment during the game? What did you kind of see from that?
Yeah, some of it is adjustments throughout the course of the game, just reading how they're guarding us. Embiid, he started off in a drop, and then they started to blitz CJ some. So kind of mixing it up of who was initiating our offense, now putting the ball in Z's hands down the stretch and seeing how they guard him and picking rolls, and CJ sort of playing cat and mouse. But, look, it's good home win, and we want to continue to build in the way that we are.
Hey, Willie, CJ broke Page's franchise record. How impressive is that to hear that, knowing, I mean, you know about Page?
It's impressive. Page is one of the all-time greatest three-point shooters during this era. And for CJ to come in and have a huge game like he did tonight and shoot the three ball well, it's a credit to the work that he and Coach Casey puts in. And CJ's he's a pro. It's what he does over and over again. He's in the gym. He's working. And it's just good to see him have a game like tonight.
Coach, did part of the game plan involve taking advantage of when Joel Embiid sat, Zion Williamson was going to be out there?
Absolutely. Embiid is such a force when he's on the floor. When they take him off the floor, we want to play even faster, try to get up and down, try to attack, not having him in the paint to block shots. Guys are getting to the basket a bit easier. But, you know, I thought even when he was on the floor, we did a great job of executing.
Can you talk a little bit about, again, it seemed like the momentum came from your bench in that second quarter where you gained some separation. I know they closed within halftime, but just talk about, again, the bench always coming through, big steals and all that.
Yeah, I thought they were huge. Our game plan discipline was at a high level tonight. I told the guys, and honestly, it's such a blessing to coach a team like this. Once again, from 1 to 17, these guys are bought in. They play hard every win or lose. They compete at a high level. They stay connected, and they enjoy coming to work, and we all enjoy working together. So it's always great to see them come in and impact the game like they do because they put the work in.
Coach, could you put into perspective the crowd at this point last season and the crowd tonight, Wednesday, Friday, sellout crowds, but also at this point last year you didn't have C.J. McCollum on your team. Could you kind of put that into your perspective as a coach and, you know, with C.J. in the crowd tonight?
You know, New Orleans is it's a special place, and this is a big-time sports town, and so, you know, it's a blessing to play in front of these fans each and every night. They're supporting our team. They're having a great time doing it. They're booing the other team, which is pretty fun, and we love playing here. We love being a part of the community here, and once again, we're trying to represent this city, this community, the right way, and it's why the guys go out and play as hard as they do.
Just a quick follow-up. We asked Doc Rivers earlier this week if the Pelicans can make the NBA Finals or win the NBA Finals, and he says no because they got to beat us. but just your thoughts on kind of the matchup between you and Doc, and I know you have history with him.
Look, Doc Rivers is one of the best coaches and people that I know. I learned a lot from watching him. I learned a lot from playing for him. And I'm still learning a lot. I steal a lot of his ATOs. And it's incredible to watch him and watch him flourish no matter where he goes. And I would have to disagree with him on the finals. Like, we definitely, we got a chance, but, you know, we know we got a long ways to go and we got work ahead of us.